Hi everybody, Henry at Tech Advisor here, and yes, it's that time of year again where YouTube is filled with best smartphone videos, but we do review a lot of them, most of them actually, so we want to share and we want to hear from you what you think the five best smartphones in the world right now are in June 2022. So when we talk about best smartphone, what do we mean? Well, we're going to use the word flagship, but flagship means a lot of different things to a lot of different people. Do we mean the most expensive phone you can buy? Do we mean the one with technically the best specs at the time of recording? Well, it's all up for debate really. So we're going to take you through our favorite five and tell you why, but do let us know what you think as well, because not all of these phones are available globally. Now, if the phone that you're thinking of doesn't come up immediately, hold on, it might be coming along down the line, but we are actually going to start with the first phone that we did in our video 6 months ago, because it really is that good. It's the Google Pixel 6 Pro. Now, if you're involved in the technology conversations, if you're a tech nerd yourself, just like we are, then you will have probably heard about all the troubles that this phone has had, but I think they are overblown. If you really dig into any software release for any phone, it's going to come up with some negatives, but the Pixel 6 Pro really is superlative in its build quality, the software, and everything that it brings to the table as the phone from Google, the makers of Android. It's also the first Google Pixel phone and first phone ever to use Google's Tensor chip. Well, that is built in-house, but it's also a bit of a collaboration with Samsung. In our use, it performs just as well as a Qualcomm Snapdragon or MediaTek Dimensity chip would, and it's definitely a reason to go for the Pixel because it seems to meld beautifully with Assistant and all of the good things that you get from Google software. Given that we are talking about Pixel, the concentration usually is on the camera, and even though you've only got up to 4x zoom, which some other phones overtake, Google's clever software does come into play as well. You have Super Res Zoom, which magically pretty much stabilizes shots up to about 10x zoom, and they really do look that good. Normally, if you were going to buy a Pixel phone, you might expect to find what has become known as stock Android, but stock Android doesn't really exist anymore. If you want a plainer version of Android, you should actually be going for something more like a OnePlus or maybe even Samsung. Google has changed Android 12 quite a lot, and it looks quite different, and some of the other manufacturers haven't picked up the quirks of its software. It's kind of a tongue-in-cheek version of Android, and I quite like it. Some of the downsides to this phone, I would say that it is one of the biggest phones I've ever used, and it's also one of the slipperiest phones. When you have a phone this big, you don't really want to put it in a case because it's already so big, but I really would recommend it on this one. Also, Google only supports 30-watt charging, which is fast, but you know, it's not actually that fast. A lot of phones are doing 65, 80, or even 100 watts now. So actually, the Google Pixel 6 Pro takes a long time to charge up. Not very pro in my book. Also, it's an expensive phone. In the UK, it's £849, in the US, $899. If you want to spend a little bit less, you could go for the Google Pixel 6, but in our opinion, you lose out on all the premium features that make the 6 Pro one of the best phones you can buy at the moment. The second phone on our list, it's a Samsung. There's always a Samsung. It's the Galaxy S22 Ultra. In the generation before this, Samsung only did an S21 Ultra and didn't release a Note. And this year, there's no Note either, but there technically is. The S22 looks like a Note with sharp edges to it rather than the curves we saw on the S21 Ultra. And yes, there's an S Pen that you can put right into the bottom of the phone. As usual, Samsung has gone all out, and this is a bit of a specs monster. It's got four cameras on the back, and two of those are telephoto, so it's already outdoing the Pixel on that front. You get 3x zoom, which is incredibly detailed, but Samsung does, as usual, crank up the saturation on its photos. It makes them Instagram ready, but it's not quite as natural as you might find on a Pixel and the iPhone that I'm about to talk about. Samsung's phones can do 100x zoom, and this one can, but it's not very good. You want the optical 10x zoom, and if you like zooming in on your subjects, then this is one of the phones you should definitely consider. As usual, Samsung makes displays and it saves the best ones for its own phones, so if you really care about crisp, incredibly high definition screens, this is also a reason to consider the S22 Ultra. One of the best things about these expensive phones is they have variable refresh rates as well, so battery life is conserved. When you don't have to scroll as much, the screen pairs it back to a lower hertz rate. In the UK, we still get the S22 Ultra with an Exynos chip. There's always been a bit of a debate about what's better, Exynos or Snapdragon, and the performance is exactly the same. Let's be honest, you're not going to notice unless you're really hammering the device. There's a debate to be had that Snapdragon will get you slightly better battery life, but this is a bit of a monster phone. It really is drawing all the power that it can from that cell. So again, this is a one-day phone. You're probably not going to get 2 days out of it, but that's quite usual for these flagship phones. It's £1,149. For $1,199, that makes it one of the most expensive on our list. I'm going to surprise you. One UI is actually really good. No, that's not a joke. It's one of my favorite skins for Android. And even though I really like what Google does with Android, I think I might actually prefer One UI. There's an argument to be had that it's a little bit cluttered, but it's stuffed to the brim with features. And particularly with the S22 Ultra and that S Pen, it's one of the most fully formed flagships of recent times. There are 5 phones in this video. So at number 3, you gotta have it at some point, it's the latest iPhone. And we think the best iPhone at the moment is the iPhone 13 Pro. There's a Pro Max as well, but we'll come back to that. Now, in the 12 series, we actually kind of thought that the 12 Pro was a bit of a black sheep of the family. You didn't have a higher refresh rate display and the iPhone 12 was far better value. That is not the case this time around. And even though we have an iPhone 14 and probably 14 Pro coming up soon, right now the 13 Pro is the one to go for. You finally have a 120 Hertz refresh rate screen, which Apple calls ProMotion. If you've seen that on the iPad Pro, you're gonna love it here. It's surprising how much of a difference it makes, and the regular 13 doesn't get it. So it's a definite reason to upgrade here. Now, I would say that the iPhone 13 Pro also has the best build quality of any phone or currently, and probably therefore ever. You get stainless steel around the edges, which gives it a really satisfying weight in the hand. It does pick up quite a lot of fingerprints, but a lot of phones do these days. The frosted glass on the back is great to hold, but you're probably gonna wanna put it in a case, aren't you? But quietly, one of the best things about the 13 Pro is the outstanding battery life. I don't really know what Apple's done, but I think, to be honest, it's probably just put a bigger battery in it. This is a slightly thicker phone than the 12 Pro. Now, another place that Apple has really caught up, particularly with Samsung and Google, who did lead the way for a few years, is in the camera department. The 13 Pro is another good reason to opt for it over the 13, which only has 2 cameras. You have 3 cameras on the back, and it's the 3 you'd expect: main, telephoto, and ultra wide. The telephoto has 3x zoom, and unlike in the 12 Pro and Pro Max, there's no difference between the cameras of these two high-end models. So if you get the 13 Pro or the 13 Pro Max, you don't lose out on any camera stuff by going for the smaller, more pocketable version. One thing that hasn't changed is that this is still the best flagship phone for video. Apple is superlative here, and other manufacturers really are going to try and have to catch up. And with iOS 16 right around the corner, you can finally customize your lock screen, a bit like on Android. And of course, flagship phone, so flagship price. They start from £949 in the UK and $999 in the US. But hey, £1,000 or dollars is par for the course with flagship phones, unfortunately. Now, I've front-loaded this video with phones that are available in the US. So sorry, US viewers, but we will give you an alternative option to this, the 4th phone in our list in this Android iPhone sandwich, the Oppo Find X5 Pro. Oppo is owned by the same company that owns OnePlus, but we think the Find X5 Pro is a superlative phone over the OnePlus options this year. The design is like nothing else apart from the Find X3 Pro that preceded it. If you get it in the silver version, it's like this amorphous, metallic, bubbling blob, which doesn't sound very attractive, but I mean, look at it. The camera bump fuses into the back of the phone. It's made out of one piece of ceramic. This isn't actually made of glass, this phone. And it is more of an iterative upgrade on the Find X3 Pro, which was so good. But that means that this is a slightly better version of one of the best phones of last year. One of the best things it does is use the same 50 megapixel sensor for both the wide and ultra wide cameras. And that's unlike any other phone on this list. What that means is that you get exactly the same color science between both lenses. The disadvantage of an ultra-wide on many other flagship phones is that when you do zoom out, suddenly the sky looks a slightly different color, people might be washed out, and usually that's because a different lens has been used, so it's just impossible to recreate. By using both of them, you get a lot more fluidity between the two, and that's something I personally really like. Here, you'll only find a 2x zoom, so if you want to zoom further than that, bear in mind that it will be digital and probably not quite as sharp. Wherever you buy the Oppo Find X5 Pro, it will have the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chip. Now, smartphone chips, they release a new one every year, Qualcomm, MediaTek, Exynos, they all have new ones, but the performance gains are quite minimal, even on last year's and debatably on one from 2 years ago as well. Unless you're really hammering the phone with high intensity tasks and multitasking, or gaming for that matter, you're not really gonna notice. But if you are hammering the Find X5 Pro, one of the best things about it is the charging speeds. Here you get 80 watts wired charging, and I can't really describe how insanely fast this is until you actually see it. It completely changes how you charge your phone. You know, you don't plug in overnight anymore with the Find X5 Pro. You get up in the morning, you might have 30% battery, plug it in. By the time you've brushed your teeth, it's gonna be nearer to 70 or 80. It really is that fast. You've also got 50 watt wireless charging on the Find X5 Pro. You do have to pay for an additional wireless charger if you want that, but you do get the 80 watt wired charger in the box. Potentially you might find Color OS, Oppo's Android skin and acquired taste. I've got used to it, but it is a little bit blobby, you know, and I still prefer how Samsung has iterated it. For example, I could not get banner notifications on Facebook Messenger, and it's just a small thing. You even have to dig into the settings to change the vibration tone for some of the apps. It's not uniform, so there are definitely some things to be ironed out there. If you're in the US, you don't even have to worry though, because unless you want to import it, this phone is not available. A sister company of Oppo, OnePlus, does have the OnePlus 10 Pro, but we still think the Oppo is the better buy, even though it's going to cost you £1,049 in the UK. Now the final phone on our list is one that we've only just reviewed, but a glowing review it was. And it's a smartphone company that is making waves in Europe, having dominated the Chinese market for quite a long time. It's the Vivo X80 Pro. Now take a look at the back of this thing. Is that a camera or is it a stovetop on a tray? Like, I mean, look at it. It's such a monster and it's a bit strange that there's so much going on here. One advantage, as my colleague pointed out in his review, is that it doesn't rock when you put it on the table because it spans the whole length of the phone. So that's actually one small thing to think about if you don't want to use a case here. But all of that paraphernalia around the back is for good reason. And my colleague Dom said in his review that this could be the best camera setup on a smartphone ever. Big words, so let's have a look at that. The main lens is 50 megapixel and incredibly capable. It's one of four cameras on the back. You also get an ultra-wide, a telephoto, and I've forgotten the other one. No, I haven't. It's a periscope telephoto, so you're going to be doing a lot of zooming here. And so much zooming, in fact, that Vivo has changed something from the X70 Pro Plus that we've also recently reviewed, because these phones come out incredibly often. On the 70 Pro Plus, they had a gimbal stabilizer in the ultra-wide camera, which was great because we use ultra-wides a lot these days, and it meant that if you wanted to particularly do video, the stabilization was off the charts. Turns out that apparently you can't either afford or fit two gimbals in the back of the phone, so the X80 Pro has moved that gimbal stabilizer onto the main telephoto lens. That means that if you're zooming in to take maybe a portrait shot of somebody, or you just want to get a little bit closer to the action, you won't get any shake on your videos or photos, and they'll be potentially clearer. You lose that from the ultra wide, which is a bit of a strange upgrade. And why am I going into such detail here? It's because this phone is so good that you actually have to pick out some of the small things about it that aren't so great or that might be different to pick holes in it. The version that we reviewed came with a lot of bloatware. You can uninstall some of it, but it's just one of those things where you can get a cleaner experience if you go for one of the other four phones on this list. Like the Oppo before it, you also get 80 watt wired charging. So the Oppo and the Vivo are the two to get if you want insane charging speeds, and shows that those Chinese manufacturers are ahead of the pack. Like a lot of Android flagships, you get the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 and all the bells and whistles that you would get on any of the phones in this chart as well. One of the downsides is that it's not available in the US, though of course you can always import. And at the time of recording, it's not actually officially out in Europe yet, though Vivo says it is coming. It's official in India, where it costs 87,000 rupees, which is about £900. So if you want to go for Vivo, you are going to have to hedge your bets a bit and spend quite a lot of money up front, because there probably won't be many carrier deals here, but we are confident in saying that this is an outstanding phone and it should be getting more attention in the Western market. So that's our roundup of the five best flagship phones you can get at the moment. The Google Pixel 6 Pro, the iPhone 13 Pro, the Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra, the Oppo Find X5 Pro, and the Vivo X80 Pro. There's a lot of pros and a lot of ultras flying around, aren't there? What is the next raft of smartphones going to be called? The megas? We're going to have to find out in 6 months. Thanks so much for watching, and as I've already said, we really want to hear what you have to say about the flagship conversation for smartphones in 2022. So let us know. Please like and subscribe our video, of course, if you like what you saw, and you'll see much more coming from TechAdvisor very soon.